The latest news headlines from the BBC.
We first encountered our next guest in when he was walking around the globe trying to bring AIDS to the attention of teens.
There's a rising tide of HIV/AIDS among young people across the globe and in the United States. We now have a youth epidemic in every country, yet few people know it. 50% of all new cases of HIV in the world are now occurring among youth ages 12 through 24. Every day, 3,000 unsuspecting teens and young adults are getting AIDS, and they don't know it. Sadly, youth are passing it on to unsuspecting partners and their future babies. My mission is to bring the news of HIV home to youth everywhere.
Well, tonight we're going to bring you the story of a local man who has dedicated his life to one cause for the past decade. He's risked his safety at times, traveling to war-torn countries, reaching out to teenagers with information he believes will save their lives.
Can I give you a card?
Yes.
And introduce myself. Dr. John.
Hi.
But it's very important now you tell your friends about AIDS and say it's moving and you can't see it. The first 3-4 years you don't know it's there. So you've got to tell your friends to be very careful.
But we need your help to talk to other mothers.
Preservative.
Okay? Because I passionately believe in my work, I have volunteered 20 years of my life to stop the further spread of youth AIDS.
Merci. Are you going to tell your friends to be careful?
Yes!
Because you don't want
In India, I met 20-year-old Saida, a mother of three who was infected at 13 by her husband. I purposely chose to hold her hand to show worried neighbors I did not fear AIDS.
You're a very beautiful young woman. So please tell your neighbors and friends not to be afraid of this young woman or her children. Not to be afraid, but to give her love. She needs love.
She helped me as a volunteer. She and her children have since passed away.
Very important, we maybe save a life tonight. Posible. No sé, I don't know. Posible. Una vida.
After training young volunteers, I tell them, now you have the power to save your best friend's life. One of the biggest problems is that many teens don't believe HIV is a personal risk. I tell them that once you know the facts, it's your responsibility to choose the level of risk you are comfortable with.
Bye. I will.
It's okay if you don't have sex before marriage. But if people do that, do not go to the prostitute because many of them have AIDS now. Among my most difficult work is visiting child brothels. Many of these young girls are sold into sex work, including this 12-year-old child. Hey, very good. Tot lam. Okay, and you take care, be good, okay? saddens me that so many people I have met have died needlessly from AIDS.
Escola.
You good luck.
Obrigado.
Teens everywhere are surprised when they hear I'm not paid to come to their country. So when I ask them to join me, they eagerly volunteer.
Okay, what is your name?
Namita.
Namita?
Yeah.
And you're going to help me today?
Yes.
Great. And I know you. And you're going to help today too, Sabita?
Yeah.
And these are your friends?
Yeah.
I take my message into refugee camps in the desert where people are avoiding civil war. Here I am in Sudan, and we are now in a refugee camp. Many of the people here are from the Darfur area, and we've been here today talking about HIV/AIDS. I go into tent cities after earthquakes to reach teens. I use what I call AIDS attacks to approach youth on the streets. They see my colorful Hawaiian shirt before they realize I'm coming to talk to them.
Yo trabajo aquí sobre prevención de SIDA con
adolescentes. We pass out business cards in each language. Each card has the most important facts and my contact information.
I'm Dr. John from America, and I have a card to give you. Okay?
Young people all over the world love having fun, and I joke with them to break the ice. In schools today, talk of AIDS and the sexual transmission of HIV are no longer taught like before, incredibly, at the very time youth AIDS rates are growing fastest. In 1994, I began the first website for teens on AIDS when the internet was still new. I answer hundreds of emails every week from worried teens. Now we are using social media like texting, Facebook, and Twitter to reach a new generation. I developed my training methods at Harvard where I lectured on AIDS. I have tested them in 100 countries. I present my research at international AIDS conferences.
Welcome to the 13th International AIDS Conference.
We also sponsor global webcasts on World AIDS Day. Well, it's a very exciting time to be here in Africa because the youth AIDS epidemic, HIV/AIDS epidemic, is growing very fast in Africa. In most countries, young people are beginning sex earlier, just like they are in every country, including the United States and Europe and around the world. Adolescence is the time in human development when teens first discover sex and often engage in risky behaviors because they feel invincible. Teens should not get HIV because adults in schools choose not to provide the necessary education. With AIDS, ignorance is not bliss. 15-year-old Alyssa is one of our teen volunteers.
I have a friend, she's only 17, and she got AIDS. And she got it from a boyfriend who cheated on her. And in school, when you guys learn about AIDS, you know, you don't take it seriously, you joke around, you're like, all right, that's not gonna happen to me. And that's what she thought until she got it, and now she's really sick. And she just wishes that someone had talked to her about it. And this is why I like to work with Dr. John and talk to other teenagers, because it's more comfortable when you talk to a teenager. It's easier than talking to an adult about this, and I wish I had talked to her before this had happened, and maybe she would have been okay.
Ben was 17 when he began working with us.
Just surfing the net, and I was like, well, I want to get into this stuff. I want to, like, put my story on something, and I found his website, and I put my story on there, and, like, a couple days later, he emailed me back. I wrote, yeah, I have it, and he's like, he thought he knew, but he wasn't sure, and he's like, yeah, and I was like, yeah, I have HIV, and it all just started from there, you know? I went down there to Mass to talk a couple of times, and now, like, I don't care if people look at my MySpace and be like, oh, well, he has AIDS. I don't care. It defines me.
You have a girlfriend that loves you, you know? Yeah. That's the only thing you gotta worry about.
Right.
Teen AIDS is in the forefront of innovative prevention techniques. Our Teen Testers program was the first in the world to take the oral saliva testing kits to youth in public venues.
The founder of Teen AIDS Peer Corps believes 100% that every teenager should be tested for the virus that causes AIDS, and his group offered free over-the-counter test kits to young people walking by Metro Center today.
Your top gum, your bottom gum, you'll put it in a vial that goes right here, and after 20 minutes you get your result back, a lot like a pregnancy test.
This family on a sightseeing trip to Washington, D.C. from Alaska sees no stigma attached to screening for sexually transmitted diseases. So when 15-year-old Caden wants to get tested for HIV, his mom says, okay.
If he feels comfortable doing this, then we fully support him. It sends a great message.
We host large entertainment events like car washes and sports days to encourage youth to participate and get tested. Without testing, youth don't know if they're passing HIV on to others.
Teen AIDS Peer Corps says that it set a new world record today when 24 young people were simultaneously tested for HIV in public.
Yeah, the idea behind that public testing is to break the stigma.
Okay, guys, let's get started on this.
These young adults took a potentially life-changing test.
Thank you.
Dr. John Chittick, a Harvard graduate and AIDS expert, started publicly testing young people last year in four states and Washington, D.C. The results of his study are being presented this week at the International AIDS Conference in Australia. We asked the teens themselves, why here in public and not in a doctor's office?
It kind of like takes the stress off, or like the intimidation off that you could be positive.
Here they say you have a built-in support group. Counselors were on hand.
Everybody here showed up clean. No one has HIVs.
So let's have a congratulations. HIV free, that's right.
So they've gone from being my volunteers in AIDS to now actually doing their own type of AIDS work, and I was very excited to see that happen and see those kids do that. That makes you feel good when you realize your work is being carried on.
The way that Dr. John taught us, he teaching, friend talk to friend, and we made a lie. Yeah, this one talk to another, and maybe this one talk to a group, and that group talk to their friends, so I think that's way is a good way.
I talk to youth wherever I find them. Whether it's in the poorest slums, in remote rural areas far from schools, or in small villages and jungles where active civil strife is ongoing. Even boy soldiers deserve to hear the medical facts. I undertook the first global AIDS walk in history because I believe it's the human right of all young people to hear the medical facts to protect their lives. My volunteers and I need your support to save more young lives.
Dr. John Chittick with some stirring information for us on this World AIDS Day. Dr. Chittick, thanks very much.